Hello, teens! Welcome to Destined Nation. I'm Pastor Jadel, and this is Monday Messengers. And every Monday, we talk about how do we become an ambassador of Christ Jesus. So, ambassadors of Christ, let us all worship the Lord.
Sing Amazing Grace.
Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved someone like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear.
'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear. Grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me, and like a flood, His mercy reigns, unending love, amazing grace. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me, and like a flood, His mercy reigns, unending love, amazing grace.
The Lord has promised good to me.
The Lord has promised good to me. His word, my hope, secures. He will my shield and portion be as long as life endures. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me, and like a flood, His mercy reigns, unending love, amazing grace, unending love, amazing grace, unending love, amazing grace.
Amen.
Hey teens, my name is Bettina and this is Verse of the Week. So for our verse for this week, it will be coming from 1 Timothy 4 verse 12. In the English Standard Version, it says there, "Let no one despise you for your youth, but set the believers an example in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith, in purity." So one more time, let's read this verse all together. 1 Timothy 4 verse 12. "Let no one despise you for your youth, but set the believers an example in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith, in purity." So for our challenge every Monday, Messengers, we encourage all of you teens to post our verse of the week, in this case, 1 Timothy 4 verse 12, on your Facebook timelines, and of course with our hashtags, Destined Nation, Monday Messengers, and I accept the challenge. So God bless and see you again next week for our Monday Messengers, and stay tuned for tomorrow's challenge in My Tuesday. Always remember, you are destined for Christ.
Hello teens, I am Pastor Jai.
I am Ivan.
And I'm Gwen.
And this is our Evangelism 101. So the Bible tells us in Matthew 28 verse 20, "Teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always to the end of age." So today, teens, let's learn about the first truths.
when you accepted Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, and that you had a personal relationship with Him, it's not just a one-time thing. When we accepted Him, it's just the first part of that relationship.
The person must make a decision to continue and to grow this relationship. It is therefore a must for a newly saved person to learn the first truths.
So what are the first truths, you may ask? Learning the first truths gives us a guide on how to grow our living relationship with God. The Bible likened a new believer to an infant. In fact, it says here in 1 Peter 2, verse 2, like newborn infants, long pure spiritual milk, that by it you may grow up into salvation, if indeed you have tasted and seen that the Lord is good. So like an infant, we find that it takes nourishment to develop, and we do this by supplying the basics of our identity.
So the first thing we are going to learn, friends, is that we are a new life in Christ. We're gonna learn about what is a new life in Christ. So that means that we get to have the basic knowledge of that you have been cleansed from your sins and that you are a new creation.
First, you have been cleansed from your sin. Now that we have been cleansed from our sin, we can now stand clean before the Lord. The Bible tells us in Psalm 51 verse 7, "Purge me with hyssop and I will be clean. Wash me and I will be whiter than snow."
Part of what God did in cleansing us is that He chose to forget our past sins as well. So Isaiah 43 verse 25 tells us, I am He who blots out your transgressions for my own sake, and I will not remember your sins. Therefore, teens, we do not live a life of guilt anymore because of our sins. We can now start fresh with God.
Secondly, you are now a new creation. So the Bible calls us to be a new creation in Christ. It says here in 2 Corinthians 5 verse 17, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed. Behold, the new has come."
So you are now a new person. That means that you will develop new habits, have new friends with you, have a different way of thinking, and of course, a new life in Christ. So this change is initiated not by our own efforts, but by the grace of God.
So there you have it, teens, for our Evangelism 101.
Always remember, teens, that God is with you till the end of the age.
And always remember, you are destined for Christ.
Hello, hello to you, teens. Welcome back to Teens in Tune. I am Pastor Crystal, and once again, we have another song featured for you that is definitely Bible-based, and the singers are solid Christians. For today's episode, that is the song Eknam, or One Name, by the group Sila. With the heart and efforts to reach the world with the gospel, the well-known group Sila has released a brand new single, yes, entitled One Name or Eknam. This song was an original Indian worship song, and this is just the beginning, as the band will release 6 more songs from 6 different countries with their worship songs translated to English. The countries: India, Poland, Brazil, Indonesia, Sweden, and France. The song Eknam, or One Name, talks about Jesus as the only way, and He has the power to change the world even today. Amen, amen. And His name, Jesus, is the name above every name. It has no equal, and people need to know about their Savior. Amen. Romans 10 verse 9 to 10, that if you confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified, and it is with your mouth that you confess and are saved. Let us listen to this song.
Listen, all you people. Jesus is
for today. That is Eknam by the group Sila. You can check it out on our Spotify playlist entitled Destined Nation, Teens in Tune. Always remember, teens, that it is important that we choose the songs that we listen to. Let God's word always be our standard in everything. You are destined for Christ. God bless you.
Hi, teens. Welcome to Compass. I'm Pastor Jadel and today's Monday Messengers. And every Monday, we talk about how do we become an ambassador of Christ Jesus. Today, let's talk about bringing someone back to the faith. James chapter 5, verse 19 to 20. My brothers and sisters, if one of you should wander from the truth and someone should bring that person back, remember this. Whoever turns a sinner from the error of their way will save them from death and cover over a multitude of sins. Now, we have to understand that some people really wander away from the truth. And some of you might say, but Pastora, that is already the truth. Why would people wander away from it? Well, you have to understand that number one, to wander means to be deceived or to go out of the way. These people who wanders away from the truth were deceived, maybe with the things of this world, maybe by someone who pretended to be someone who cares for them. Many reasons, but they were deceived. They were not necessarily unbelievers. They used to believe in the truth that comes from the Word of God, but because of an influence, a deceiver, who caused them to be deceived away from the truth, they wandered off the path that leads to God. Now, wandering should be something that Christians should avoid. Like the prayer of David. In Psalm 119 verse 10, it says here, with my whole heart I seek you. Let me not wander from your commands. Now, this is David coming to the Lord in prayer and telling God, Lord, I do not want to wander away from your commands because God's word, it is the truth, right? And we do not want to wander away or be deceived that God's word is not something that we're not supposed to live according to. Our heart should always be walking in the ways of God, being fully convinced that God's word is the path to success and prosperity. It is the path that leads to eternal life. It guides us each and every day of our lives so that we can live our lives worthy of the call that God has placed over our lives. That's why every day we should come to the Lord. Come to Him and tell Him, Lord, I want to be renewed according to your word so that I can walk according to it and live a life that pleases you. Now, when people wander from God, it is a place of poverty. They're heading towards a place of poverty. Amos 4 verse 8. So two or three cities would wander to another city to drink water and would not be satisfied. Yet you did not return to me, declares the Lord. When people are away from God, and we do not want that, but when people are away from God, they get thirsty. They are never satisfied with the things that they have because this world will never ever satisfy you. It is a downward path towards poverty. Without the blessings of God, we cannot live this life successfully, and we cannot live this life exponentially. We also have to acknowledge that away from God is not a place of joy. We know that in the presence of God, there is fullness of joy. But when people wander away from God, they were deceived, they wander away from the word, from the truth, it is not going to be a happy place, and it's not going to be a happy ending. Now, what do we do when one of our friends or someone that we know or we care about happens to be wandering away from the truth? The Bible says, let's bring the person back to the Lord. James 5 verse 20, let him know that whoever brings back a sinner from his wandering will save his soul from death and will cover a multitude of sins. It is a command for us to bring back someone that we know is wandering away from the truth, to bring them back into the knowledge of the truth. Now, when you see someone, for example, and they're gonna fall into a manhole and you're beside them. And you know, they're talking, they're not paying attention to where they are walking, and you saw that they're gonna fall in a manhole. What are you gonna do? Right? You're gonna grab that friend, whatever parts of the body you will be able to grab, the hair, the hand, what, the leg, whatever. Right? Because you want to save that person from sure harm. In the same way, if you're gonna lead someone back to the Lord or remind them of their ways, of the ways that is the truth that comes from the Word of God, then you are saving that person's soul from sure death. 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 16 says, "All scripture is breathed out by God and profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness." You have the Word of God. Do not just convince the friend with your own words. Your words doesn't have power, but the Word of God has power. It is at work in a person's life. So, correct, rebuke, teach, use the Word of God. Psalm 19 verse 8, "The precepts of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The commandment of the Lord is pure, enlightening the eyes. The fear of the Lord is clean, enduring forever. The rules of the Lord are true and righteous altogether. More to be desired are they than gold, even much fine gold. Sweeter also than honey, and dripping of the honeycomb. Moreover, by them is your servant warned. In keeping them, there is great reward." Now we know that, right? We know that by the Word of God, we are warned the way we live our lives. And in keeping the Word of God, there is a sure reward. Knowing all of these things, these are more than enough reasons why we need to remind someone who we know is wandering away from the faith to come back to the Lord Jesus Christ, to once again be convinced of the way they need to live their lives, because we know that it's going to end well for the righteous. We need to care enough for someone whom we saw is in a downward path, in a downward hill, by making sure that we rebuke them and correct them and teach them the Word of God. Because we know that only then, and by living the way God wanted them to live, will they receive a reward and will they be led into the path that leads to the Lord at the end. So teens, look around. Look at your friends. Where are they right now? Are they still living for God? Right? If you know someone who needed help, a reminder, an encouragement to come back to the Lord, let you be that person who will encourage that friend to come back to the Lord. Save that person. Save his soul in Jesus' name. Now let us pray for you. Heavenly Father, we come to you in Jesus' name. And Lord, speak to us and open our eyes to the needs of other people, Lord. Especially, God, friends who are wandering away from the truth as of this moment. Help us, Lord God, to speak the Word of God to them, to correct them, to teach them, Lord, through the Word of God. And we know that even now, your Word is working in their lives, O God, and it will produce fruit of righteousness. We pray that they'll come back to you and make a decision for you once again. Lord, nothing is too hard for you, and we know that even now, you're working on their behalf. Father, we commit to you, O God, our friends, and we pray that together, we will walk side by side in serving you and in living for you. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Thank you so much, teens, for being here with us at Destined Nation today. See you again tomorrow, 5 o'clock. God bless you.